So thank you for the invitation, Rodolfo, and I'm really happy to be here after the first symposium. And I hope there will be a continue in the next years. So in this talk, I will show you how we got to the conclusion that the cats have a long-term olfactory memory and why it can be important for them, and also why we have to be cautious when we interpret results like this. So for a long time, we know that olfaction has a great importance in a range of contexts, especially in altricial mammals. Altricial youngs usually born with closed eyes and ears. So for them, olfaction is the most important guiding sense in the nest. For example, when they try to locate their mother's nipple, or even later when they have to discriminate their mother from other conspecifics, it seems olfaction is the final decision step in this discrimination or recognition process. And also some studies on rats and rabbits which used artificial scent have demonstrated that encountering and learning a scent at early life can last long, and animals can have long-term memory even into adult life of it. But to our knowledge, only one study has demonstrated long-term memory of the mother's odor. Hepper was who found that dog pups are able to recognize their mothers as early as the fifth week. And for this recognition, only olfactory cues are enough. And even after almost 2 years of separation from the mothers, the adult offspring were able to discriminate the mother's odor from other conspecifics. And why is it important? Because in the case of mother's body odor, studies from other species also have been suggested that recognition of it can serve in different biological functions like kin recognition or mate choice or other nepotistic behaviors. So why we choose the domestic cat as a model species for this kind of study? The cat, in contrast to the dog, rabbit, and the various commonly studied rodent species, is an essentially solitary animal. And we thought it provides a good comparative opportunity to the understanding the function of such early olfactory learning. We know that newborn kittens are able to locate the mother's nipple right after birth, and presumably guided first by pheromonal and then by learned olfactory cues. We also know that kittens develop a nipple order, meaning that every kitten has its own designated nipple. And although it is not known how they keep this order steady, but very probably they use olfactory guidance for that. And also still blind kittens are able to locate their nest if they get out, apparently also using only olfactory cues. So thus in this study, we asked whether kittens learn the body odor of their mother and distinguish it from the body odor of other females, and if they retain the memory of the mother's body odor and continue to distinguish it from the odor of other females even after long separation. And to answer to this question, we used 58 mixed breed short hair kittens from 15 litters and from 8 mothers. And these cats were all from a free ranging cat colony based in a private house in Mexico City. At this site, at least during the study, communal nursing has never occurred, and mothers showed little attention, if any, to the litters of other females. So the first test was conducted with the kittens when they were 8 weeks old. And at this time, they were still at their nursery room at the cat colony. And it was just before they were given away as a pet. And the test was repeated with these subjects in their new homes when they were approximately 4 months old, 6 months old, and over 1 year old. And Since not all kittens were available for all the tests, because sometimes we were not able to visit the cats when the when its test was scheduled, or sometimes the cats cat was not willing to participate in the test, thus the sample size varied at each age of testing. Yes, so we designed a three-way choice test for the cats, and each subject was presented simultaneously with three other samples on separate cotton swabs. One was the whole body odor of their own mother. The other one was a whole body odor of from an alien female. And the third one was a blank control swab. Each sample was collected with this type of swab, what you can see on the picture. It's a 15 centimeter dry, sterile, swab, which was rubbing in a standardized way on the donor's cat face, chin, back, ventrum, and anogenital area. And we use separate swabs for each trial from each donor. And for testing, we also match the reproductive status of the donor females to that of the mothers as closely as possible. So for example, if the mother meanwhile got neutered, the alien sent donor was also an neutered female. Or if the mother was still gonadally intact at the time of the odor collection, the other donor female was also an intact female. And we also used the swabs for testing within 30 minutes after the odor collection. And we transported them in an insulated bag containing an ice pack, and also the samples from the mother and from the alien cat for the same trial were collected within 20 minutes of each other. This is how the test looked like. The three swabs were presented simultaneously to the subject, attached to a plastic ruler approximately 1.5 centimeter apart. And the order of the swabs was always randomized. The tests were conducted by two experimenters who were familiar to the cats. And while one of them held the camera at the base of the swabs, recording the cat's nostril close up, the other one gently restrained the cat if it was necessary, letting it sniff but not touch the swabs. And the trial ended when the cat turned its head away. We also, if the cat did not sniff all the swabs, we excluded the trial from the analysis. And from each trial, the duration of sniffing of each of the three swabs was recorded, and the duration were registered in this software called Solomon Coder. We also assessed the inter-rater reliability, and for that one of the rater was blind to the identity of the swab, but still we found a very good agreement between them. And let's see the results, what we found. At first, we haven't found any sex effect across the trials, and only age had a significant effect, meaning that kittens sniffed the swabs for the least time when they were 2 months old and for the longest when they were 4 months old. And in this figure, you can see the results from the 2 months of age kittens. Both sexes clearly discriminated between the swabs and sniffed the alien mother. Here, both the females and the males, the alien mother sent longer compared to the other two swabs. And then 4 months, the pattern was less clear. Actually, the female seems not discriminating anymore between the own and alien mother's odor, but the males changed and sniffed the swab with their own mother's odor significantly longer. So actually, if we had we stopped testing at this age, which is already 2 months after the separation, we might have falsely concluded that the cats retain little or no long-term memory of their mother's odor. Or maybe that the mother's individual odor signature changed with time. However, we continued the test, and seems neither of these explanations would have been correct given the results of the 6 months and the 1 year old test. At these later ages, subjects showed very similar pattern of responding. Females and males both sniffed the swab with their own mother's odor significantly longer than either of the other two swabs. So let's summarize these findings with a little bit of explanation. So at 2 months, kittens of both sexes discriminated between the swab and sniffed the alien mother's odor significantly longer. So for that, we can think of two explanations which are not mutually exclusive. The most obvious explanation is that the kittens were habituated to the odor of their own mother, to which they had been almost continuously exposed since birth, and so gave more attention to the novel odor of a strange mother. And actually, this is consistent with the results, what they found in dogs and rats, where the young around weaning show greater attention to the unfamiliar scent compared to the familiar ones. Although in these papers, the authors interpreted this as an attraction to novelty. At 4 months, since females did not show significant difference in sniffing any of the three swabs, but males sniffed the swab with their own mother odor significantly longer. For the female's behavior at this age, we can only speculate. And we found that the closer examination of the data showed that actually we can separate the females in two groups, one which significantly sniffed the own mother odor longer, and those who significantly sniffed the alien female's odor longer. This means that the female kittens at 4 months of age do discriminate between the two odors, but not in a uniform way. And then 6 months and 1 year, both sexes of the subject showed very similar patterns of responding, clearly discriminated between the swabs and sniffed the own mother's odor significantly longer. So these results suggest that kittens of the domestic cat retain a memory of their mother's odor for at least 10 months after permanent and complete separation from her. Moreover, the similarity in the results of the test at 6 months and 1 year of age suggests that the kitten's olfactory memory of their mother's odor may endure even longer. And this in turn implies also that the mothers retain some form of stable individual odor signature, enabling later olfactory recognition by their young, although the nature and the origin of such cues is presently unknown. But what does this mean that the cats have such long-term memory of their mother's body odor? And that they have the ability to discriminate it from the body odor of other conspecifics. What does this mean in functional biological terms? And we can say perhaps nothing more, but nothing less than that the subject recognized the familiar odor and responded to it with a longer examination. And so without the need to invoke more specific cognitive representations, such as the recognition of a kin. And actually, this would be consistent with the minimum needs hypothesis, which argues that since complex recognition system can be costly in terms of time and or energy or even neural processing, they evolve or are expressed only if less complex form of recognition or discrimination between individuals or categories of individuals will not suffice. But actually, such a general response might then be sufficient to serve a multiple function according to the context. For example, our results could be tentatively interpreted as providing support for the inbreeding avoidance hypothesis. However, the literature on this topic is quite controversial, with respect to the importance of this in the cat. One study has reported that females avoid breeding with close kin, but others reported that mating among close relatives in the cat is not a rare event and not even necessarily genetically maladaptive. And in other contexts, the recognition of a familiarity might be useful is the occurrence of nepotistic behavior. For example, under high density or at clumped food source, social groups of cats can form, and it is not a random aggregation of individuals. And they observe that at these sites, communal nesting is also reported, which most often happens between mothers and daughters. And without being over speculative concerning the functional meaning of our results, we can conclude that kittens retain memory of the body odor of their mothers well into the reproductive age, nearly a year after being separated from them. And this suggests that long-term olfactory memory might not necessarily relate to the species' social or ecological background, since the cat is considered only a facultatively social species. And in the other way, we can also conclude that the mothers retain an individual odor signature sufficiently stable across age and not affected by changes in the reproductive state to be distinguishable by their adult offspring. And what can be the next step after this? And it would be good to investigate the hypothesis of the operation of a more general olfactory memory system that gains functional specificity from the context in which the stimulus is encountered, and thereby providing a warning against possible overinterpretation of the cognitive representation of long-term odor memories. And thank you for the attention.